Well, that's what we don't know, because we've never had it. So therefore, we examine things as we go along and say, what is the most constructive result? I mean, fire will burn, water is wet. We just start with some of the elements, the basics. I mean, when is a person hurting? How much is the hurt? We start measuring things. Everything is by comparison. This is the only way that you can ascertain what justice is. And so that's an evolutionary process. You have 10 people in a room, and you just start with, okay, everybody in here needs some help. I'm giving this as an example. We're assuming that everybody in here needs some help, because people do need help of some kind every day, whether they're aware of it or not. But everybody needs some type of help. So you just say, okay, we've got 10 people in this room. We're assuming everybody needs help. Who do we start with? We start with the person by just having everybody present what they say they need help with. Then, through that process, you find out who needs help the most. And you even discuss that. Because some person will say, well, that doesn't seem like you need more help than me. Well, let's look at it. Let's examine it. Because we're talking about constructive help here. And you'll say, well, what is constructive? By the results. So this is the process by which you do it. And you go through each and every person in that room. Find out what they need help with. Give the person that needs help the most the help that the person needs, if it's possible to do so. Then you go to the person who is being mistreated, find out what the mistreatment is, and eliminate the mistreatment. What's the best process for getting rid of the mistreatment? Because justice is about guaranteeing that no one is mistreated and guaranteeing that the person that needs help the most gets the most constructive help. And I think through that simple process, it can be done. And it can be done in a short order, short period of time. And just follow that process through every day and every situation throughout the entire world. Because right now we have no standard for something called justice. That's why we have chaos, which is mostly what we have.